the fuck?
Hello, I'm Christopher Collins, and I just wanted to go over some additions I've gotten to my camera equipment recently. Recently, I've gotten a new camera bag because my last one, it had a tendency to break all my my camera UV filter. So I wanted to get a new camera bag that was slight. It was an in-between size of what I've already had of this huge camera bag from Canon versus what I've had before. So far, this is a really good camera bag, I've noticed. I've only had it for a week, but I've liked it so far because it has an equal weight distribution. It carries all the photo equipment I want. It actually carries more than my smallest camera bag I had, but less than the Canon one. I've also got different compartments for flash drives in here. I can put side pockets on here for different things. I like the straps. It's quieter than my last bag I had. It doesn't hurt my back wearing it. It's got different pockets here, and here it looks like this. Or what the example on the picture came with is this or this, depending on which way you want to carry your stuff. For a photographer or a videographer, I've had this for a couple of months, but I haven't really gotten the chance to use it until about July or August. But this is a camera lens skirt. It goes over your camera lens like this, so that, and you basically use the suction cups of this lens skirt for like a window of a car or an exhibit or something like that. And so you would have it like this. You'd have your lens like this. You can tighten it here. It's got one of these twist things on it. And what this does is this reduces the back reflections. And I really like this because it's good for more than just getting out reflections. I use this for my camera. If the screen is too bright outside, I can put this over my camera, put this over it, and then I don't have to worry about, I can see better my screen in bright situations. It's good for if I'm looking at my device, like a phone or something, or an iPod, and it's really bright outside and I can't see what I'm doing, I can put that over my phone and then I can still watch like a movie or can see my screen better. It's also really useful for if you're outside and it's a really windy day, you put this over your camera mic of your camera body or something like that, and this will reduce the sound from the wind sound, so you don't have that annoying wind sound. You put this over your camera and that wind sound will go away.
Welcome back to the gospel account of Jesus' life and ministries. In chapter 5, verses 21 through 24, he says this. This is Jesus talking to his crowd. Okay? In that moment, your choices. You can brake suddenly, or you can just run into the car. So there's not a lot of options there if you don't want to get into an accident. That can upset a lot of people. I remember when I became a father and I drove around, I went from driving 5 over the speed limit. Where's Bill? I'm telling on myself here. Bill, shut your ears. So I went from driving 5 over the speed limit to 10 under it because my baby was in the car. And I drove around with such a safety and protection because if anyone dare cut me off or road rage, I was going to lose my mind at the wheel. They're just going to see in the windshield this guy banging on the steering wheel going, "Are you kidding me?" And just yelling and losing his mind. Why? Because something I love more than anything is in the back of the car. I didn't get myself in trouble with anything I said. Put those cuffs away, sir. We're not at the jail anymore. But what Jesus is doing, we can get there.
Also, it's really compact and it fits in the back of my camera. So I find that aspect very useful, the fact that it's so portable, small, doesn't take up that much space. I also recently went to Michael's and they had this light for, I don't know, about somewhere between $16 to $12. I'll probably write the price down, but it's a camera selfie light. And what I like about it is it's very light. It doesn't weigh very much. It's actually what weighs the most is the batteries in here. It has only 2 AAA batteries. And that's what's taking up the most weight, or else this would be really, really light besides the batteries. And it has a clip. So I can attach it to my camera or to my phone. But I use this, what I find this useful for is if you're at nighttime or something like that, and you're in a dark room or something like that, you can use this light to help brighten the situation. There's a switch on the very bottom underneath the flashlight, and that's how bright it is. It's very bright. So, gives you an idea of how bright it is. But this is a really useful tool to have. And it doesn't cost very much, and I can twist it any way I want. So if I want it to face down, face up, so that I don't have a direct light, I can make it that way with this little light. So it fits perfect into a camera. And I recently got a special filter for my Nikon 55-300 lens. It's a 58mm lens. It's a solar lens that you use for the sun. Recently, there was a solar eclipse, and I looked up a lot of different videos on what kind of filters to get. This is called a hydrogen alpha filter, right here. And I got really interested in trying to capture the sun for the eclipse, but unfortunately, I didn't have the money by the time I learned about this special filter, but it's a hydrogen alpha filter, so you can get more detail on the sun. And it's a very red filter. I don't know if you can even see it or not. That's what you'll see if you use this filter. Looks very red. And although I believe I probably need another filter to go for it, because even at the highest shutter speed and the aperture as small as possible, like an f/29, this is still showing that the sun is overexposed, so I'll have to get another like a neutral density filter for this lens. But what I've gotten with the results are really cool. So it does some unique things. This is not a cheap filter. It cost me $118 American dollars at B&H for. So now the length skirt here, this cost around $45. So, and then this camera bag I got, this is probably one of the cheaper items besides that light. And this camera bag from Rugged is a pretty good company for camera equipment. For bags, I've also gotten in the past their rain skirt for rain for protecting your camera. But I like this camera bag actually better than the rain skirt I have, because the rain skirt is so complicated. But this is really useful stuff right here. And this is $20 for this camera I got at B&H. This I got at B&H. The camera bag and the lens skirt I got all at B&H. The only thing I did not get at B&H was this camera light. So, highly recommend all these items. And that is all. If you'd like, please subscribe to my Instagram and Twitter. There's all kinds of pictures on my Instagram, so you can check that out at Instagram. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.